बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। वेलकम टू सांदल कॉलेज बॉयज सेक्शन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। हेयर इज अख्तर सईद, योर इंग्लिश टीचर विद अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट लेक्चर ऑन द पैसिव वॉइस ऑफ प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस। I'll tell you four steps with the help of which you can change any active voice of present continuous tense into passive voice. Let's embark on today's lecture. Here comes a sentence of present continuous tense: I am teaching English. As you know, I am teaching English. A sentence has three parts: subject, verb, object. I here is subject. Subject is actually a doer of action, an actor. It performs some action. I am teaching is verb. Verb is the action done by the subject. It is verb. Third part and last, that is object. Object is something that receives the action done by the subject. So a sentence has three parts: subject, verb, object. I'll tell you four steps with the help of which we can change it into passive voice. Step 1, that is, this object will take the place of this subject, and here we'll write the subjective form of this object. As English is a noun or name, it will be written the same, English. Step 2, this subject will take the place of this object, and the objective form of subject will be written here. But before that, we'll write by, then objective form of subject. As I is subjective form of pronoun, we'll write by me. Step 3, that is the third form of the verb. These three main steps are followed in the passive voice of all the tenses. There is only one change, that is step 4, and this step 4 will be different with all the tenses. This object is actually the same, English. We'll see in present continuous tense, if English is singular, we'll write is being after that. If this object is plural, we'll write are being. If this object is I, we'll write am being. These are the four steps, dear students, which will be followed for all the passive voices of all the tenses. There are certain small changes, that is, if the subject is name, it will remain the same, by Ali. Ali is by Ali. We will be changed into by us. You, by you. We, by him. She, by her. It, by it. And they, by them. These are the subjective pronouns and these are the objective pronouns. Now, we'll change this sentence, I am teaching English, into passive voice following these four steps. Step 1, that is, this object will take the place of this subject. We'll write English here in the beginning of the sentence. Step 2, this subject will take the place of this object. We'll write by me. Step 3, that is the third form of this verb teaching. It is taught. English. Taught by me. Now step 4, that is the selection of helping verb. English is singular, so we'll write is being here. English is being taught by me. This is the passive voice of this active voice of present continuous tense. I am teaching English. If you want to change it to negative, we'll write just not after this helping verb. Dear students, where there is helping verb in a sentence and you want to change it into negative, just write not after this helping verb. For example, you can write is not being, are not being, or am not being. English is not being taught by me. If you want to change it into interrogative, you will write this is in place of English as it, and this English will be written after this is English, then there will be no other change. Being taught by me, is English being taught by me, and question mark. if you want to change it into both interrogative and negative, you will write not here. Is English not being taught by me? Is English not being taught by me? Dear students, I hope you might have got the idea how we can change the active voice of present continuous tense into passive voice. Let's see some more examples. Dear students, I have written the chart of 4 steps that we will follow to change the active voice of present continuous tense into passive voice. It will help you if you find any problem. Let's start sentence number 1. We are collecting old coins. A sentence has 3 parts: subject, verb, object. We, subject, are collecting verb, old coins, object. Hum purane sikke jama kar rahe hain. Step 1, this object will take the place of this subject. We'll write old coins in the beginning of the sentence. Step 2 is subject will take the place of this object. We'll write by us. Step 3, that is the third form of verb collecting. It is collected. Old coins collected by us. Step 4, that is the last step. We'll see if it is singular, plural, or I. Old coins is plural, so we'll write are being here. Old coins are being collected by us. Old coins are being collected by us. Sentence number 2. My father is advising me. Mere wala sahab mujhe nasihat kar rahe hain. My father, subject, is advising, verb, me is object. Step 1, that is the change of object and subject. This object will take the place of this subject. It is objective form, but here we will write subjective form. It will be I. Step 2, subject will take the place of this object. We'll write by my father. Step 3, that is the third form of verb advising. It is advised. I advised by my father. Step 4, that is the selection of helping verb. We'll write am being because of this I. I am being advised by my father. I am being advised by my father. Sentence number 3. He is not leading the procession. Wo julus ki qiyadat nahi kar raha hai. Dear students, just consider this not is not written here. Now the sentence is he is leading the procession. He, subject, is leading, verb, the procession, object. Step 1, this object will take the place of this subject. We'll write the procession in the beginning. Step 2, that is the change of the subject with the object. So we'll write by him. He changes into by him. We'll write by him. Step 3, that is the third form of verb leading. It is led. Now 4 step, that is the selection of helping verb. The procession is singular. So we'll write is being. The procession is being led by him. Now the sentence actually is negative, so we'll write not just after this helping verb. The procession is not being led by him. Dear students, where there is helping verb in a sentence and you want to change that sentence into negative, just write not after that helping verb. The procession is not being led by him. Let's see some more examples. Sentence number 4. Mr. Aslam is teaching us a lesson. Subject, Mr. Aslam, is teaching, verb, us, object, a lesson, object. There are 2 objects here in this sentence. If there are 2 objects, how we can change such sentence into active voice, I tell you. Step 1, this object, a lesson, will take the place of this subject. We'll write a lesson here in the beginning of the sentence. Step 2, subject will take the place of this object. We'll write by Mr. Aslam. Step 3, that is the third form of verb teaching, it is taught. And the second object will remain with the verb. Taught to us, we'll add 2 here in passive voice. A lesson taught to us by Mr. Aslam. Step 4, that is the helping verb. A lesson is singular, so we will write is being. A lesson is being taught to us by Mr. Aslam. A lesson is being taught to us by Mr. Aslam. Now we'll see the same sentence. Sentence number 5, Mr. Aslam is teaching us a lesson. Here we used this object, a lesson, in the beginning of the sentence. Now we'll use this us as object in the beginning of the sentence. Us will be changed into we as we'll use subjective form of this object here, we. Step 2, that is Mr. Aslam's subject, will take the place of this object here. So we'll write by Mr. Aslam. Step 3, that is the third form of verb, taught a lesson. The second object will remain with the verb in all the passages. We taught a lesson by Mr. Aslam. Step 4, that is the helping verb. We is a plural subject, so we will write are being. We are being taught a lesson by Mr. Aslam. We are being taught a lesson by Mr. Aslam. So if a sentence has two objects, we will change it in this way. A lesson is being taught to us by Mr. Aslam. And second is, we are being taught a lesson by Mr. Aslam. Sentence number 6. Is Bashir buying a new motorcycle? It is interrogative. Just consider for some time that is not here. Bashir buying a new motorcycle. It is simple sentence. Actually, it is Bashir is buying a new motorcycle. Bashir subject, buying verb, a new motorcycle object. Step 1, this object will take the place of this subject. So we will write a new motorcycle in the beginning of the sentence. Step 2, this subject Bashir will take the place of this object. So we will write by Bashir. Step 3, third form of verb buying. It is bought. A new motorcycle bought by Bashir. Step 4, that is the selection of helping verb. A new motorcycle is singular, so we will write is being. A new motorcycle is being bought by Bashir. Actually, this sentence is interrogative. What we'll do? We'll remove this is here and we'll change it here in the beginning of the sentence. Is a new motorcycle being bought by Bashir? Is a new motorcycle being bought by Bashir? And never forget to put question mark at the end of the interrogative sentence. Let's see some more examples. Sentence number 7. The students are decorating their school. A sentence has three grammatical parts: subject, verb, object. Subject, the students. Verb, are decorating. Object, their school. We'll follow four steps to change it into passive-wise. Step 1, this object will take the place of this subject. We'll write their school in the beginning of the sentence. Step 2, this subject will take the place of this object. We'll write by the students. Step 3, third form of verb decorating, it is decorated. Step 4, that is the selection of helping verb. It is being, because their school is singular. So the sentence becomes, their school is being decorated by the students. Sentence number 8. My mother is cooking food. Subject, verb, object. We will follow those four steps to change it into passive-wise. Step 1, this object food will take the place of this subject. We will write food. Step 2, this subject will be written at the end of the sentence, by my mother. Step 3, third form of this verb cooking, it is cooked. Step 4, the selection of helping verb. Food is singular. We'll write is being. Food is being cooked by my mother. Food is being cooked by my mother. Sentence number 9. Who is knocking at the door? It is a bit complicated sentence as it is interrogative. Where there is who, just consider that this who and this helping verb is are not here. The sentence is knocking at the door. The door is object here, so we'll write in the beginning of the sentence, the door. Then third form of verb knocked at. Then the selection of helping verb. The door is singular, so we'll write the door is being knocked at. The door is being knocked at. It is interrogative. First, we'll remove this is from here and we'll write it in the beginning. Is the door being knocked at. Now this who will be changed into by whom. By whom is the door being knocked at. By whom is the door being knocked at. And question mark at the end of the sentence. Where there is who in the sentence, please follow these steps so that it must be very correct. Let's follow some more examples. Sentence number 10. The shopkeeper is selling vegetables. A sentence has three grammatical parts: subject, the shopkeeper, verb, is selling, object, vegetables. And we are to change it into passive voice. Step 1, this object, vegetables, will take the place of this subject, shopkeeper. So we'll write vegetables here in the beginning of the sentence. Step 2, this subject will take the place of this object, vegetables. We'll write by the shopkeeper. Step 3, that is the third form of verb selling. It is sold. Now, the selection of helping verb. If this subject is singular, we'll write is being. In case of plural, we'll write are being. And if there is I, we'll write am being. Vegetables is a plural word, we'll write here are being. Vegetables are being sold by the shopkeeper. Vegetables are being sold by the shopkeeper. Sentence number 11. They are singing a song. They, subject, are singing, verb, a song, object. Step 1, that is, we'll change this object with this subject, they. Will write a song here in the beginning of the sentence. Step 2, the subject will take the place of this object. Will write by them, as they is changed into by them. Step 3, that is the third form of verb singing, it is sung. Step 4, that is the selection of helping verb. A song is singular, will write is being. A song is being sung by them. A song is being sung by them. Sentence number 12. Why are you making a noise? Interrogative. Just consider that why and are not written here. And the sentence is you making a noise. It means you are making a noise. It becomes assertive sentence. If you follow these steps, it will be easy for you to change it into passive voice. You here is subject, making verb, a noise, object. In step 1, we'll change this object, a noise, in place of this, you. We'll write a noise. Step 2, this subject will take the place of this object, a noise, by you. Then third form of this verb, making, it is made. Now a noise is singular, we'll write is being here. A noise is being made by you. As it is interrogative, obviously we'll write this helping verb is in the beginning of the sentence as it is. Is a noise being made by you. Here is why. We'll write this why as it is in passive voice in the beginning of the sentence. Why is a noise being made by you? Why is a noise being made by you? And never forget to write question mark at the end of this interrogative sentence. Please follow these steps to avoid any mistake. Let's see some more examples. Sentence number 13. They are playing football in the ground. They, subject, are playing, verb, football, object. In the ground is the complementary phrase. Actually, it is adverb phrase of place. In step 1, this object football will be written in place of they subject. football. Step 2. This subject will be written in place of the object. We'll write by them as they changes into by them. Step 3. The third form of verb playing, it is played. Football played by them. Step 4. That is the selection of helping verb. It is as being because football is singular. Football is being played by them, and then this phrase in the ground. Football is being played by them in the ground. Sentence number 14. Is this officer neglecting his duties? Dear students, it is interrogative sentence, and be very careful when you want to change any interrogative sentence that is in active voice and you want to change it into passive voice. Just consider that is not written here. This officer neglecting his duties, it is simple sentence and it might be easy for you to change it first into passive voice. Subject: this officer neglecting verb, his duties object. In step 1, this object his duties will be written in place of this officer. We'll write his duties. Step 2, subject will take the place of this object, that is by this officer. Then step 3, that is the third form of verb neglecting, is neglected. Now step 4, the selection of helping verb. His duties is plural, so we'll write are being. His duties are being neglected by this officer. Now this sentence is interrogative, and in interrogative sentence we'll write this are helping verb in the beginning of the sentence, so we'll write are here. Are his duties being neglected by this officer? Are his duties being neglected by this officer? And question mark. Dear students, last but not the least, sentence number 15. Where is she washing clothes? It is again interrogative sentence. Just consider that where and is are not here. She washing clothes. She is subject. Washing verb. Clothes object. Actually, this sentence should be she is washing clothes. Present continuous tense. In step 1, this object clothes will be written in place of this subject she. We'll write clothes here. Step 2, this she subject will take the place of this object clothes, and we'll write by her as she changes into by her. Step 3, that is the third form of verb washing, it is washed. Clothes washed by her. Step 4, that is the selection of helping verb. Clothes is plural, so we'll write are being here. Clothes are being washed by her. It is interrogative, so we'll not write are here, rather we'll write are here before clothes, are. And before that we'll write where. Where are clothes being washed by her? Where are clothes being washed by her? And question mark. That's all of today's lecture, dear students. I hope you might have got the idea how we can change the active voice into passive voice. I would advise you to watch this video lecture once again for better understanding. Then, if you have any question, if you have any problem, you may comment in the comment section below. Inshallah, I'll be there to answer your questions. Till some next lecture, take a very good care of yourselves and your dear ones. Thank you very much.